as the study of matter in relation to energy. Isn't that right, Ian?
Yeah, that's right.
So, physics.
It's the study. Matter in relation to energy.
So in physics is majorly divided into six branches, namely mechanics, geometrical optics, waves. Can you give us advance?
Electricity and magnetism, thermodynamics. And you also have atomic physics. First, I can expound on magnetic and on mechanics. Mechanics is the study of motion of objects. Under the influence of forces. Remember, forces is either a push or a pull. Therefore, mechanics is the study of motion of objects under the influence of different forces.
We also have electricity and magnetism. Electricity and magnetism is the study of
Electricity and magnetism deals with the study of electric currents and electric currents and magnetic fields and their applications. Therefore, we can say that electricity and magnetism, as a branch of physics, is the study of electric.
But aside from that, we also have atomic physics. Atomic physics being
Atomic physics as a branch of physics deals with the study of the atoms and structures and other objects constituting the nucleus and as well as their charges. Therefore, we can say that atomic physics is the nucleus and their charges.
Oscar will then expand on other branches of physics.
The other three branches of physics are thermodynamics.
From here,
Now, here, the other three branches of physics are thermodynamics. My friend will expound a little bit on thermodynamics.
Thermodynamics, as you can see, is formed by two words, that is thermal and dynamics. Thermal meaning heat, thermal, therefore, and dynamics. Thermal meaning heat, and dynamics meaning pressure. Therefore, Oscar can give us the full definition.
Now, thermodynamics, this is the study of heat, the heat transformation to and from other forms of energy. Then, here we have geometrical optics. This is the study of light as it traverses through different forms of matter. And lastly, we have waves. Waves is the propagation of energy. Then, physics is a very new subject to all form ones. We'll be dealing with the how physics applies in other subjects, such as geography, history, religious subjects, mathematics, but let's give the core of this. Geography, the application of physics in geography. The application of physics has been used in the manufacture and designing of objects such as compasses, thermometers, barometers, hygrometers, and many others. Now, history. Physics has been applied in objects such as in history. We will study about different ways of dating. Fossils are ancient artifacts that we studied in history. The application of physics has been used in carbon dating. And the making of compasses. These compasses use the rule of magnetism. Religious education. The organization in the solar system can be well attached to the Creator, who is God, or to the Muslims God Muhammad. So, this physics helps in finding details that agree with the facts in religious education. Mathematics, as you study in the other topics, most of physics physics topics require computations, which are calculations in short. So, my friend here, Ian, will expand on that. Subjects.
More to that, you can also say that mathematical concepts and principles and formulas such as multiplication have been used to manipulate physics concepts. For example, in physics you can also learn about area that uses the principle of mathematics, which is multiplication. More to that, you can have other subjects such as biology, chemistry, home science. And even agriculture. In biology, physics concepts have been used to make and manufacture the microscope. It has been used to manufacture the microscope. Physics concepts in the making of the lenses that are used in the microscope have been used in biology to study the microorganisms. In chemistry, the study and principles of physics have been used to define the structure of the atom, and forces within it, as explained in chemistry. In home science, many of the manufactured goods that apply the concepts of physics, such as the refrigerator, apply concepts of physics. In agriculture as well, the manufactured appliances such as the harvesters use physics concepts in them. Oscar can then take it from there.
Yes. Now we'll be learning about career opportunities in physics.
Now, in physics, when you study physics, there are many career opportunities that can be found in the study of this prestigious subject. Now, we look at the career opportunities in physics at university level.
Yeah, we have many careers, but we only have 5 examples, such as bachelor in dental surgery, bachelor in medicine. For those who want to become doctors, physics is a major subject in that career. Bachelor in technology, such as computer science, textile technology. Yeah. So here in medicine, you can become a medical doctor, maybe a dentist. Or a medical doctor. Or even a nurse. There are many career opportunities here. And another career choice here that you can study about is
in surgery. This is mainly for those who want to become surgeons, cardiologists, all those. Bachelor in surgery. So physics is a major contributor in your career. My friend can dwell in at university at a diploma level.
Not to that, and just but also add on this. We also have Bachelor of Engineering, for those of you who like to be electrical engineers, this is the subject to dwell on most. You can also have education. At the education level, you can either become a teacher more to it, you can become a researcher. A researcher in that. In that you are a physicist. And that's what you have for you. Career opportunities. You can therefore move on.
Now we move to basic laboratory rules. We are still under introduction.
Now, first we should ask ourselves, what is a laboratory? A laboratory is a special room equipped with the necessary facilities to carry out experiments in science. So, under laboratory, we can look at laboratory rules. Now, in the laboratory, there are sockets, special chemicals, and other in the flow, and some dangerous chemicals here. So, here, we need to be guided by rules. Isn't it, Ochako?
Yeah.
Yes. Now, the first rule, one should not eat or drink in the laboratory. Now, this is to prevent contamination. In the laboratory, almost every surface is contaminated with either chemicals or that. So you should not eat or drink while in the laboratory. And here, another point is, one should not run. One should not run. You should walk and not run in the laboratory. This is to prevent accidents such as chemical, somebody being poured on with chemicals, such things. Then, you can also expand on, do not touch electrical circuits with wet hands. We all know that electric shock can cause paralysis or, moreover, cause death. So one should be careful while handling electrical sockets. The last point we'll be dwelling on, because there are so many, we'll be dwelling on one should not. One should not touch or play with another person's experiment. This is to deter, you know, one may be doing something and he has left it halfway. Maybe an experiment is going to the toilet. Then you come playing the experiment. This may cause electric shock or scalding. We'll look at that in our next subtopic. Now, Ian Chapel, can you expand more? Can you give us more laboratory rules?
More laboratory rules, I can expand on the electrical appliances. First, you must note where the location. You must note their location. More to it, you must also know that you cannot go on entering foreign appliances such as the biros, cannot, you should not therefore go on entering foreign appliances such as the biros into some of the electrical appliances such as the sockets. This can cause an electric shock, for instance, because the biro has some portion of it that is metallic, that therefore metal is a good conductor of electricity. I don't think I have any other to add.
Just to expand on this one, this can cause food poisoning. Now, we can now move on to injuries which can be caused in the laboratory. Now, the main injury which can be caused in the laboratory is mainly electric shock. Some of us may be very adventurous, and everything you see you want to touch. So one may in the case of electric shock, seek medical attention from a teacher. First, you need to, we have all been taught first aid. So you need to remove the place at which the body is into contact with either the socket. So as to prevent him from death or paralysis. Then after moving the body, the place at which is in contact with the socket, one should seek medical attention from a teacher or the laboratory technician. Another injury can be called poisoning. Now, my friend Tiano Chapo can respond on this.
Due to your lack of, maybe your lack of expertise in poisoning, you should therefore immediately seek further attention from any adult. What we would like to expand on the electric shock, before you remove the body from the object which is causing the shock, should remember electricity passes through blood, which, and blood therefore has water, and you also have water. If you touch the body, you can therefore transmit the electricity to yourself. So first, before removing the body, you should therefore switch off. Electricity that is causing the shock. More to it, you can have other injuries caused by chemicals. Chemical injuries such as chemicals falling on your skin. You should first of all, on the skin. Chemical injuries caused by chemicals falling on your skin or coming into contact with your skin, you should first of all run cold water on the part that is infected with the chemical. If in by mistake or in any case you find that the chemicals have gone into your eyes, the most appropriate thing to do is to also rush off, run water, or rather wash your eyes with your eyes. With cold water, because of due to lack of assurance that this will cause the effects of the chemicals on causing further damage, should therefore then after taking this procedure seek further medical assistance and the rest. Oscar can then take us from there.
Just to explain the chemicals and minerals. This process is called scalding. Now, in all these cases, seek assistance from either teachers, laboratory personnel, or medical personnel. Now, from here, we're going to move to. Now, you and Chapo can take us, can take it over to the next subtopic. Mm-hmm.
What I'm sure to just summarize or eating.
Now, to summarize what we've learned today, or rather discussed, we've learned the introduction to physics. Introduction to physics. To us all, physics is a very new subject. And we've learned that physics is the study of matter in relation to energy. Then we've learned about branches of physics. Here we've looked at various branches such as atomic physics, waves, and geological optics. Then we've learned about career opportunities. Physics, we've seen that physics comprises of many careers which you see in our day-to-day lives. Even your physics teacher has worked on this subject. And lastly, but not least, we've worked on laboratory tools. And just before that, we've worked on application of physics in other subjects. But last but not least, we've dwelt on laboratory rules and the meaning of a laboratory. Thank you for watching.